Children of cheapskates, what are some of the ridiculous things your parents have done to save a couple of bucks? When my dad moved into his house, he had a guy come over to do a free demonstration for a water filter that goes under a sink. The guy used a bar of soap for his demonstration and left it when he was done. My dad called at least 4 other companies for a free demonstration just to keep the free bar of soap, and never intended to have a water filter installed. He does things like this, and it gets worse as he gets older, but I just let him do his thing. So much effort for soap, lol. It does get worse as they get older. I don't think my dad would have pulled the Fabuloso thing 5 years ago. Crazy old coots. My mother tried to convince ticket seller that I was 6 years old, actually 12, and my brother 12 years old, actually 19. To save 6 bucks for a hop in hop off bus ticket. Needless to say, my mother did not get the reduced price, especially because of the reason my brother was smoking a cigarette. The exterior of our family minivan must have been 70% duct tape by the time it was retired. It was a running joke that we'd put fresh patches on before a big event like a wedding or prom. My ex-stepmother was like every Disney stepmother ever. She was loaded but was super stingy. When we all stayed at her house, she made my dad bring our own food every time. One time we forgot, and she fed us 65-seed tin tomatoes. I don't understand people like this. If you're marrying someone, you're not just marrying them, you're joining their family. If they have kids, those kids are now your kids too. I never understood how people could treat their stepchildren so poorly, or how parents could let their new partner get away with such crap behavior. I've been getting re-gifted presents for Christmas since I was a kid, and not like presents from other people that were then given to me. Number. We're talking my favorite jacket goes missing for 6 months only to be found under the tree as one of my presents. Just had my 30th birthday gifted a Swiss Army knife I had when I was a kid. When my parents had the family home refurbished, Pa would carefully extract the nails from the ripped out woodwork with a claw hammer, and then hammer them straight again and put them in tins for reuse along with unused nails. For years afterwards, every third or fourth nail you used from his workshop would bend like a banana on first wallop from a hammer and you'd hit your thumb. I'm not sure how old the person who saved the nails was, but my grandfather used to do this. He was born in 1900, and when they would tear down a barn, he'd save all the nails and straighten them during the winter. My dad tells me it was because when he was growing up, nails were a luxury, so straightening old ones was common practice. Seems crazy, but it kind of makes sense too. When my grandmother and grandfather got married, they did their gift registry with Sears. That was back in the day, late 1940s, when they had a lifetime guarantee on almost everything they sold. My grandmother has moved house almost 10 times since then, but she has kept every single flat and box and warranty for every appliance she got when she was married. About 2 years ago, I drove her to Sears to get her iron replaced. She brought all of the boxing and paperwork from all the way back in the 1940s to get a new one. They actually did fulfill the guarantee and gave her a new iron. I think it's hilarious, but she literally hasn't had to pay for a new appliance in over 60 years because she's so cheap. She's a Ukrainian immigrant to Canada, and she always insists lifetime guarantee means lifetime guarantee. I kind of feel bad for Sears because our family are notoriously long-lived. Her father lived until 104. I sometimes think that maybe this is the reason why Sears is doing so poorly. A ton of cheap old women cashing in on their lifetime guarantees. Sears is doing poorly because they cheapened out on the quality of their tools and got rid of the lifetime warranty, aka the major reason why people went to Sears. My father would drive literally across town, several miles out of the way to save 2 or 3 cents per gallon of gas. He would also drive 60 miles to the casinos for a free meal, but was too cheap to go to a restaurant and buy one. My parents taught me never to buy drinks or dessert or snacks when going out. Those things are much cheaper at the grocery store in bulk, and you just have to wait until you get home to enjoy them. I miss my parents. Bonus. Uncle would put drumsticks in shrink wrap and hide them in his pockets to take to the movies. Then again, our family still has a picture of him from college in the 1960s, a new immigrant to the US, holding a bag of coins at the payphone, with a huge smile on his face. His dorm mates surprised him at Christmas with a bag of coins so he could call his parents overseas, just for a few minutes. Thank you, Baylor University. Ducks, I never buy that stuff out either. It's a racket. I'm the lady at the baseball game with a purse full of snacks and peanuts because I refuse to pay $10 for nuts. Ex-wife was a frugal spender and always tried to save money or make extra money where she could. After our divorce, my family would still gift our children clothes on the holidays and their birthdays, until I found her selling the clothes on Craigslist and then go to the Goodwill to get cheaper clothes for them. Now my family makes sure I get the clothes. They go stay with her with what they were sent with. My mum used to buy my underwear from second-hand stores, then my parents would spend money on cigarettes, alcohol. I must have been the only 13-year-old who went to school in a small used maternity bra. Mum would date richer guys around the holidays so we could have Christmas presents to open. My mom used to tell me that peanut butter and tortillas are what Jesus ate. My dad always refused to buy me a fish supper from the chip shop. Said it cost too much, and I could have fritters instead. Not really a big deal. Until a stray cat moves into his house, he decides to keep it, and regularly treats it to fish suppers. You deserve fish suppers, Gabdom. Don't you forget that. Parents would pick a place when going out that had some sort of kids under X years old are free, and I had to be 3-4 years younger than I am for the day. My GF's son was already over 6 featuring at age 10. That ship sailed years ago. She had the hardest time convincing people he really was 10 years old. She ended up just giving up on trying. My girlfriend's parents went to McDonald's on their first date and used a coupon. I will have a Big Mac, and my date will have something of equal or lesser value. My dad returned a video game I got on my day so he could buy it cheaper from the Middle East. There was Arabic language option. So after playing a little bit on my birthday, I had to wait another week until it was delivered. Me and my brother used our own money we saved up together to buy the PS2 when it came out, along with Red Faction for a game. Our dad said it didn't look any different graphics-wise to our PS1, so he took it all back and pocketed the money. I used to get ants in my cereal boxes and my mom would still make me eat it. They don't do that anymore, but it made me realize how financially stressed my parents were until 10 years ago, because now they waste more food than I do. This happened to us once. Ants were in the peanut butter. My grandfather, who cherished us grandkids, got upset with my grandma for letting us eat UBC. He said we might choke on the little bones. Miss my papo so much. My dad wouldn't let us eat on Sundays. We had to fill up on free samples from Sam's Club. It was humiliating. He isn't even hurting for money. He's just selfish with it and spends hundreds on himself. Computer parts, games, in-game purchasing, comma, my dad wouldn't let us eat on Sundays. Wait, what? My mum would wait up to an hour for the bus that cost 5 pence less. She lived in a house worth nearly £1 million. My dad once sent me a raccoon skull and an old hat that he got off a friend as a Christmas present. The skull still had some flesh on it. Well, at least, NVM, I can't come up with any way to make that not weird as frick. When I was in high school, I took taekwondo classes a couple times a week. My folks had instilled in me never start something I cannot finish. I worked up to the belt before a black belt, but the black belt test was about $300. They convinced me to stop taekwondo. Water in my cereal instead of milk. I honestly don't know if we were that poor or if she was lazy and didn't want to load up 4 kids in a vehicle and take them to the store. I have oats with water. My soap calls it imitation brand orphan gruel, because it's not fancy enough to be regular orphan gruel. My dad would always go under the speed limit on the highway, going around 80-90 kph maximized fuel efficiency, so that's how fast he would go. We also drove a car until it was literally falling apart from rust. Had about 400k kilometers on it and just about everything was breaking or had broken. Constant check engine light, bad brakes, no horn or emergency brake. It took a cop pulling him over and deeming the car non-roadworthy. I got a Twinkie with a candle instead of a birthday cake 1 year. When dial-up came out, we got a free month's trial CD. We used it for almost 10 years by frequently setting the date back on the computer. My mom once gave me a little pillow for my birthday with a sausage print. I was like, ah, thanks, that's interesting. She said, yay, well, I actually bought it for the cat, but you know she got run over, so now you get it. My mom adds water to condiments to make them last longer. It gets to the point where you're eating vaguely ketchupy water. My mom would shove salad into an empty salad dressing bottle, shake it up, then fish out the slightly dressed salad. I posted this before and eventually had people telling me that I'll never have money because I'm not this crazy frugal. My grandmother found out that the late fee on her water bill was less than the cost of a stamp. For years and years she would skip every other water bill and just pay both bills at once. It wasn't that she didn't have the money, it was that once she found out about the slight difference her cheapness took over. Share bath water. My brother would get in first, then me and then mum or dad would be last. It's pretty gross thinking about it now, but at the time my parents did it to save money on the water bill and gas bill because they were on really low incomes. My mother put strict rations on toilet paper. Yes, she was an butthole. My dad figured out where the giant industrial rolls you see in some shopping centers are sold and moved us over to that. It's like one giant butt roll with about 3 or 4 normal rolls worth of TP. I've never been so embarrassed having friends over. The worst was my aunt. She was driving to see us and within my family is known as Aunt Cheapness. She drove with her husband, now ex, for 12 hours. Normally the trip should have taken 6-7, but she drove extra slow to save gas. The crazy thing was keeping all but the front windows shut and no AC the entire ride. It was the start of a heat wave and when they pulled into our driveway it was over 100 degrees. My three cousins were drenched with sweat when I saw them climb out of the car, and I rushed them into the house for water and air conditioning stat. I think my dad had a talk with her later because that's the sort of thing that gets kids killed. She has gotten much better since then, but I will never forget that story. I remember my mum would fill up the name branded cereal box with a cheap alternative every week. When using a payphone I had to call my folks collect and tell them what I wanted really fast during the say your name thing. We had a buy it's a boy, I remember that commercial. One time I wanted to buy this girl a bouquet of flowers to show that I cared for her. My mother said that the shop was shut, I knew it wasn't, and she went to the supermarket and bought her a sandwich instead. Freaking absurd present really, but she did like it at least. It was ham and mustard. Not sure if this qualifies because I chalk this up to just being poor more than cheap, but my mom would take us to McDonald's once every month or two to treat me and my brother to our own milkshakes and we would split a large order of fries. My mother wouldn't ever order anything for herself, but while we were waiting she would walk over to the condiment stand and stuff fistfuls of ketchup into the bag with the fries. When we got home she would spend a good hour sitting at the kitchen table squeezing each ketchup packet into our ketchup bottle to refill it. She also used to wash and reuse Ziploc bags multiple times. When I was in the 3rd grade I accidentally threw a shovel at my older sister like a javelin. Unfortunately for her it hit right between the eyes and went down to the bone. Instead of going to the hospital my parents decided they could do it themselves. Both have PhDs BTW. To save money. So me and my dad went to Walgreens to pick up supplies and when we got back my mom stitched up my sister. 10 years later and her scar is almost completely gone. No lasting damage. And I have a great story to tell so I guess it worked. I wouldn't call them cheap. More like they were poor, but once for dinner my dad took all the coupons, game pieces, and anything conveying free fast food and decided to make a dinner out of it for us, four kids. So we drove from store to store redeeming mostly game pieces and things like raffle tickets where every ticket was worth one order of fries or something like that. Anyway, at Burger King they charged him something like 7 cents tax and sure enough on the coupon it said taxes not included. Instead of handing her a dime my dad created a massive scene arguing with a 14-year-old, holding up the line, being loud and argumentative, demanding to see the manager, etc. I was 10. It was horrible. Of course by then I had realized my dad was an insane, horrible pose, so it wasn't altogether a surprise but I was really embarrassed every time the work glanced down at me. Oh, I might be able to win this thread, but it wasn't my parents, it was Enzo's dad. He would only let them run hot water from the kitchen sink because the water heater was closest to the kitchen, so it would have taken a few extra seconds of wasted water for it to get hot in other rooms. No showers, and if you wanted hot water in your bath, you had to run it into a pot in the kitchen sink and fill the tub with multiple trips. Buy crappy things that would break or wear out quickly, requiring us to buy more crappy things shortly thereafter to get by. I didn't realize this was an issue until I dated a girl who came from an upper middle class family. They bought things that were high quality. I'm talking shoes, coffee makers, lawn chairs, and their stuff was both better than mine and lasted far longer. Nowadays, I drop more cash on brands I know are worth it. For example, I wear Charcot sandals. Even though they cost $90, they outlast any other shoe, let alone sandal, I have ever purchased, can be resold for cheap, and are comfy to boot. My father always used to say we are not rich enough to buy cheap things. Dang right, Pops. My so's dad is hilariously tight in weird ways. He taped a button over on their $900 vacuum so you couldn't use it on the max setting. It's got a full rechargeable battery, but you can't use it on max because it will use more power to charge. Oh my god, dads are terrible. Mine hates paying for electricity, so he hangs his clothes up outside, which would be fine if he didn't do it year round even when it's below freezing. Whenever my sisters or I would clean our rooms, he would go through our trash looking for valuables we had thrown away, money or recyclables. He's obsessed with gas prices, and I once sat in the car with him as he drove around town for half an hour searching for the cheapest gas. When he wants to drive down a hill, he literally puts his car in neutral, opens the door, and pushes himself down the hill with his foot. One time we went to a Burger King and I was only allowed chicken fries because a burger was too expensive. My grandma would try and buy me second-hand underwear from Value Village. Put a stop to that pretty quick. Stopped insuring me and taking me to the doctor because I was a hypochondriac and it was expensive. Actually had ulcers. After those got diagnosed, she made me tell the doctor the meds were great because they were the cheapest on the market. Actually were killing people. Propulsed. Also refused to bring me to the dentist. Ever. Not flush the toilet. My mother also tried to continue with that terrible decision when she came to stay at my and my, now ex, husband's home. Needless to say, I put a stop to that in a hurry. She was, still is, an incredibly scrodgy gift giver. The last birthday present that I received from her, 3 years ago, was a pocket spiral notebook. Nothing says happy birthday quite like a mother who goes to the effort of showing you that she knows that it is your birthday but simply doesn't give a crap about putting any thought into a gift. She probably fished it out of her handbag just before seeing me and thought, meh, this will do. My dad strains cereal milk back in the bottle. It's disgusting. My mom hates it, but he still does it when she's not around and there's milk left in our bowls. You have been visited by the money bird. It'll bring you good fortune, but only if you subscribe in 42 seconds or less. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check out another video, or don't. Either way, have a great day, you magnificent people.